Welcome to Let's Play Enderal. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, the RPG chick, and this is a Skyrim mega mod, or total conversion mod. It's not even, they've changed everything, basically. Or almost everything. It's, not only different lands, different NPCs, voice acting, different music, the skills are different, spells are different, level up system is different. They've changed so much, they've done a lot of work, and it's all for free. You can find it on Steam, among other places, I believe, for, you need the original Skyrim, or the Skyrim Legendary Edition. The Skyrim Special Edition, the remaster, will not work. They'd have to do a lot of work just to get it to work with that one, so. Unfortunately, this is, version or patch 1.5.7.0, which was released on July 7th. So from my standpoint, when I'm recording, that was yesterday. So that fixes a lot of bugs and stability. They've improved stability and performance and all that stuff, so they're very good. I'm playing this blind, which means I have never played the game before. No, I am not blind. This is a blind run of Enderal. I've played up to... A lot of people think I am blind. I put that in the title. I've played up to where you talk to Father and he tells you to go into the house and stuff. And that's about... That's it. I just wanted to make sure his voice wasn't booming loud over mine. And it's pretty much a little lower than mine, I think. So it's pretty good because I try not to talk when... other people talk. I play slow and methodically, just so you know. Some people like that, some people get frustrated with that. That's the way I play. See my Skyrim playthrough for that. Me playing in much the same way, I imagine. The proof is in the pudding, but this is not pudding. I have played Skyrim 596 episodes. To about 322 hours of gameplay uploaded. So, you guys want to see that, go see that. And I've played other mods as well. Was it Falscar, Worm's Tooth, and Beyond Skyrim. Oh, and Moonpath to Elsewhere, which is a short one. Recent reviews on Steam are overwhelmingly positive. Some call it the best RPG or one of the best RPGs of all time. People have compared the story, the quality of the storytelling, to Planescape Torment, which of course piques my interest. Planescape Torment is one of my favorite games of all time. So I think that's all I have to say, and we begin a new game. Many Enderalians keep dogs as shepherds for hunting, or even just as loyal companions. Okay, hopefully that message at the top will go away. Started. A nice day in summer. I have to talk with Daddy. He wants to tell me something important. So apparently we are playing some kind of child. Oh, we're in a cart. I've tried various things. I've tried climbing this stuff to no avail. There's really nothing else. You can't climb that ladder. My frame rate's pretty good, but it's jumping all over the place between 48 and 60, pretty much. Oh yeah, I like to show... Okay, journal. Yes, I understand. Now my settings. I'm playing on Adept difficulty. It goes to Expert, Master, Iron Path, where you can pay the iron price, but I'll play on Adept rather than Apprentice or Novice. Saving, stuff like that. Mod config- oh wait, actually look at display, have things like this. Oh, that's the bottom. Mm. Subject to change, of course. I keep hitting that audio. Seem to hear me pretty good. This is the default audio, so I haven't changed anything here. Mod configuration. I've messed around with this. Yeah, open. What's the hero menu? Meditation, this is different. Phasmalist? I thought it said pharmacist. Call apparition. So this is different stuff. H. And Sky UI is included. Awesome. Great. Great overhaul of the items. So as to not be in console mode with items and such. Controls, these are my default controls. I use a tactical board, not a keyboard, although I do have the keyboard in front of me and use it to press certain things like inventory and such like that. But my main control is with the left hand using the tactical board. But people might be wondering about that. Now, I don't know why they show you. Look at that. Diseases contracted. Learning books read. Tavern games. I guess we're gonna be playing tavern games. This might be a little spoilery. I don't know. Magic. Favorite school. I haven't even looked at this stuff. So apparently we can get in trouble and have such stuff tracked. A horsey. Nutritiousness of meat. There's only two pages, so I'll just read it. Meat is life. Even the Ash people who are populating this world before us knew that. Each time they killed an enemy in a battle, they tore out the liver and heart of the fallen and ate them together with their family. By doing so, just as everyone knows, the strength of the beaten army is passed on. But as we are living in a time in which eating fellows is nonsensically seen as barbaric, we, the friends of the bloody meat, have to settle for animal sources. Oh, brother. Now, even though I rebinded the keys, it still said E for take. This should be left control. Now, unfortunately, you can't see here, I don't think, like what kind of anti-aliasing and such I'm using. Display. Wish I could tell you. It's either anti-aliasing, I think 4. Anti-aliasing times 4. I don't even know what else. There's a separate configure thing that shows up, such as same as with Skyrim. You have that option. So we have sprint. We have jump. What's H hero menu? Doesn't do anything. Here's our inventory. So we have the book. These are. That's a. Oh yeah, book and scroll. Okay. Maps. Aerial perspective. All we can see is air. Local map. Okay. Home sweet home. Alright. Journal. I have to talk with Daddy. He wants to tell me something important. Before the patch, this said something important, and then down here, I think it said something special. Alright. Where even am I? I'm running up here. Now there's something over here. Some winged goddess or angel or something like that. Read scribbled note. O Lord, O Maker, I can hear you calling. I feel your love. I know about your sacrifice. Without you, I am nothing. A twig on the currents of time. A sheep without shepherd. Free me from my vices and forgive me my trespasses. Forgive, too, my wife and my child. Deliver me from my pains and bless us with your everlasting mercy. Yeah, I read everything, guys. I don't think there's a lot to read. I mean, it's a voiced and everything. But where there is reading, I will read. Of course, this is a long book. I'll probably put that in a separate video. Let's read the books of Enderal. We can have a series on that. Am I running faster with sprint? I can't even tell. Oh no, that's sprint. There you go. Just pressing the wrong button. There's father. I haven't looked over here. There's nothing over here. Now something interesting if you want to take a peek. Apparently beyond this is nothingness. Or we're just very high up. Oh, I think I got myself stuck here once. Wait, we got out. See that? It's pretty spooky. Alright, let's go talk with Daddy. Oh, Daddy! We might have a word with you as I crash into rocks. Alongside the fence. Literally. Your stamina is low! That hasn't happened before. Power. They weren't showing me that here. Should show up here. Just not in this prequel. Beginning part. Prologue. Pretty standard. For Skyrim.
Oh, hey there. I didn't see you coming.
You weren't looking.
So, how did it go? Did you find it?
Find what? What is this place, Daddy? Where are we?
Where are we? We're at home, silly. Where else would we be? Just Mommy, Sister, you and me. Now tell me, how did it go? Did you find it?
What does he want us to find? No, I didn't.
No? Pity. Maybe you're simply looking in the wrong places. Did you ever think of that? Well, who knows. Say, why don't you go inside and see if you can help Mommy with the cooking? The Creator was kind to us today and sent a big fat elk right in front of my bow. Alright?
Yeah, he put the elk there in front of your bow. Is that how it works? Well, he won't talk anymore. He just sighs. Kill me, Daddy! Ready? Here it comes. Ugh. Now, I wasn't able to open this door before I talked to him. Tomatoes! I can't take peppers, though. How sad. Got some knives. Mushrooms. Oh. You can take an entire urn. That's creepy. Trapdoor requires key. Forbidden door requires key. That's a dresser? Enderalian penny. Coins. Ooh, a garnet. Yeah, I'll take that stuff. Now I can hold 360... Is that pounds? This kid's tough. This is one strong kid, and that doesn't look like... Plain? I'll take that. I'll leave the basket. Ooh, really? The Art of Crispy Meat. This is only two pages again. Who doesn't know that? You're looking forward to a nice crispy piece of meat after a hard day of work, but your useless child, who you instructed to cook it, gives you a charred something instead. You castigate them, but the problem stays the same. You are hungry, which means that there is no other way than doing it yourself. Walk to the fireplace, cut out a big bloody chunk of the animal, and throw it into the kettle. And lo and behold, slowly, the pleasant smell of burned life reaches you nostrils. Is there anything better than that? I don't think so. We could take multiple copies. This is what we had before, nutritiousness of meat, yeah. Yeah. is people like meat. Oh. Oh, one of those creepy dolls that you see. What is this? Cheese? Cannot take the cheese. Can't take the Pac-Man cheese. How sad. That requires a key as well. This whole place is locked down. Daddy's savory meat pies. Ingredients. 2 pounds of minced meat. 1 jar of flour. A handful of bruised garlic. How do you bruise garlic? A handful of ground whisper weed. Half a jar of meat broth and a pinch of sugar. You have to make that at some point? Take wine. Oh god, these people are cannibals. Oh, that's spooky. Okay, you're creeping me out now.
My, my, I totally forgot what a mess I left here. But I was right, wasn't I? A real gem we've got here. Well then, let's waste no more time and get to it, shall we?
Yeah, but what about Mommy and Sister? And why is everything locked?
What? Now would you look at that? I totally forgot about them. They're dead.
What?
Don't you remember?
What?
You murdered them back then. Both of them.
Back when?
Hey, no use crying over spilled milk, right? At least this means there's more meat for the two of us.
I murdered them.
You still remember how to do this, right? First, off with the skin. Slice up the belly, then out with the entrails. I'll look for a nice sharp knife in the meantime, to cut off the head. I don't think either of us wants to eat that, do we?
Is that how I killed Mommy? From up to the entrails? Okay, these are all the same. But I didn't kill them, Daddy. It was the masked men. It was the one-armed men.
Oh, silly. What's this again? We both know that's a lie. You did it. I remember it all. First, you set this horrible fire to your sister's crib.
What?
She screamed and screamed, and Mommy heard it, but when she finally got there, nothing was left of her but burnt flesh.
Oh, my God.
And... oh, gosh. Do we really need to go through this again? You know how sad it makes me when you do this. You killed them, period. No matter how often you tell me you didn't, it changes nothing. You hear me? Nothing. Now, please, let's start cooking. I'm so bloody damn hungry.
These are all the same. How about I choose the last one? It was the masked men.
Oh, by the creator's name, why are you telling these lies? Isn't it enough that you murdered us? Do you really have to bother me over and over with your stupid, pathetic, and pointless whining? You know, sometimes I wish the creator would have made me just a little less merciful. Just a little less pious. Because then... I would have realized that you were tainted by sin long before any of this had ever happened. And instead
tainted?
Of raising you, feeding you, and loving you like a father does, I would have put you in the horse trough right after you were born. Yes, I should have killed you. I should have just killed you.
This is wonderful.
Just like you killed us. And now, you think you're safe because we're all under the earth, don't you?
Well, I killed you too?
Well, listen up, my child. You are wrong. And do you know why? Because the dead don't forget! Do you hear me? The dead don't forget! Now enough of this useless chatter! I'm bloody starving! Bring me the meat, you spoiled brat! Bring it to me!
But you're
Bring
dead!
Bring me a nice crisp piece of meat! 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 Bring me a nice crisp piece of meat!
Oh! Okay. First quest completed. I think this is going to be a little darker than Skyrim.
Let's begin with a question.
Okay.
It might sound simple to you at first, but I pray you to think about it. What distinguishes a free man from a slave? For now, however, let us start this story where another one ended 3 years ago, with the death of the Lightborn. For 4,000 years, they had reigned over this world, seven Arcanists, who, through their magic, had acquired eternal life. In a time of chaos, they gave mankind what they thought it needed most, to be ruled over with an ironclad, fair hand. Within just one century, they united the shattered lands, and a single century later, their human origin was forgotten. They became gods, or lightborn, as they let themselves be worshipped as. Yet the longer they reigned, the louder the voices grew that accused them of tyranny. The loudest being that of Naranzul Aranthiel. And he succeeded in achieving what was once thought impossible. He gathered an army, overturned the Lightborn, and gave back freedom to mankind. However, the price for this was high, because where there are gaps of power, fights erupt. As such, this world grew into what it is today. Shattered, riven, and broken into pieces. But all of this was merely a diversion, so that no one would notice something else. The death of the Lightborn had set something into motion, a clockwork. Having long stood still, its gears now once again slowly began to turn. This is the story of someone who wanted to be free.
Well, that's pretty impressive.
You want to wake up the entire ship or what?
Sirius Black?
Well, sorry. That was a bit harsh. I'm just nervous, that's all. It was that dream again, wasn't it?
Oh, so I was dreaming the whole time. That makes sense. I was wondering. Yes.
Seriously, if we had a penny for every night since we met where you woke up screaming, we'd probably be traveling to Enderal in our own starship, and, well, not like this. Some things never change, I guess.
Starship?
Do you ever ask yourself if maybe you blame yourself for all of this? For what happened to your family, I mean?
Was it me, or was it the Masked Man? Those bastards from the temple killed them. So we're getting a little exposition just from our dialogue choices here. I don't know, maybe. The dream seems to indicate that, but even if I do, what difference does it make?
None. You're right. But who knows? Maybe everything is going to be different now. It's strange, isn't it? The way life sometimes goes. If you had told me that a few weeks ago, I would have at the very least called you insane.
Now don't rule that out.
But if the stories are true, there's no better place for a fresh start. Can you believe it? Apparently there aren't even any slaves on Enderal. It's amazing. Only this whole blind passenger thing is making my head ache.
Blind passenger. So it's a novel thing to be in a land without slaves. So freedom seems to be the overall theme of this story. We're going to have to pay our debt as soon as we earn some money. Okay. It's not our fault that the ship is so poorly guarded, and we couldn't have afforded the passage fee anyway.
Not our fault. Damn it, we're thieves. Frauds. And unlike you, I actually have a problem with that. But anyway, what's done is done. I just hope the Andralians are easier on Outlanders than the Neremese are.
Nerem!
Your mother was a fugitive as well, wasn't she? Where exactly did she come from? You've told me 100 times, but I just keep on forgetting it.
Okay, character creation. Now, Nerem, he referred it to Nerenese. Nerem is their other game, which was a total conversion mod for Oblivion. Hef Eterna. Name is me. Alright, let's read about these races. Native to the swampy continent Myar Aranath, the destruction of the land caused by decades of war forced many Eterna to escape to other countries where various destinies awaited them. Some pursued and disregarded them because of their innate magic talent. Some revered them for it. Many Eterna earned their life as traveling minstrels. Half Eterna earned with a bonus for elementalism, entropy, mana, and enchanting. Now, entropy is the way things break down. Everything breaks down over time, so entropy, can you, like, speed up the breaking down or destroying of things? Half Azurelian. Originating in the barren and steppe-like continent Araziel. Okay, Araziel. The Arazielian are divided people. While the nomadic natives in the steppes maintain their pantheistic traditions, the coastal inhabitants regard them as primitive and struggle for recognition as a fully-fledged part of the civilized world. No bonus on this? Half... so it could only be half stuff. Half Kalanian? As a secluded people, the inhabitants of the belt of Kalei are said to have a reclusive mind. Kalanians are deemed as blessed businessmen, a rumor that can be ascribed to the Blue Island Coalition, which is Vin's biggest trading company, is located in Kalei, among other things. Half Kalanians start with a bonus on rhetorics, carrying capacity, sleight of hand, and marksman. Cool. Do we have to play a male? Kuranians. Half Kuranian? Kuranians originate from the namesake desert continent, which is said to be both barren and inhospitable. At the same time, it is also known as cradle of science, mysticism, and culture. While many foreign countries admire Kyra for its advanced culture, they are often deemed as heretical and immoral, especially on religious continents like Enderal. This is a religious continent. Okay, that's what Enderal is. It's the cradle of science, mysticism, and culture. Well, I'm going to take the hit on a lot of people in Enderal not liking me and go for possibly being from an advanced culture and being possibly skilled in science, mysticism, and or culture. Okay, good. That's better. Just want to see how they look. Oh, this is like your elven type. So, these people look like to be from maybe, you know, someplace similar to Hammerfell, am I thinking right? But yet, they're more an advanced culture. Somewhat. Oh, you can change skin color. Not that much. Oh, interesting how it changes. You'd think this would be darker, darker, but then it changes there. It's almost red there. Yeah. make her a little skinny, just for the hell of it. Alright, so that's that, and then head. So what is this, add circles under her eyes? Okay, that's better. Oh, there's already circles there. Oh my god! I think this one? Well, this one, what's the difference? I don't know. Dirt? No dirt. How about no scars? I always go for no scars, no tattoos, yeah, freaky. I like tattoos, but not on the face. Oh wow. Alright, so that's that, and then face. Nose types. That's fine. I think it's all fine. You can... Well, I'm changing nose length. I was looking at the other thing. I thought it was on this. I don't even see a change. You can see it there. Okay. Did I make her nose very long? I can't even see the difference. Oh, yeah. Okay. Cheekbones. Eh. Laugh lines. Cheek color lower. Nose color. Chin color. I think the color is fine. Head color. Oh. Yeah, that looks a little better because they're... I don't know if it's a light here. No. Eye shape always seems to be something you, for the most part, don't want to mess with. I mean, that one's not bad, but okay. Let's keep it like this. Eye color. Bloodshot eyes. What you been smoking? Oh my god, freaky! Eyes, you have Storm when she has the black eyes. Oh, Storm had white eyes when she used her power. Yeah, I'll stay the same. Eye height, eye width, eye depth, eyeliner. Makes her eyes look... Oh, she already has eyeliner on. It's not always color, that's the whole style of the eyeliner sometimes. Eyeshadow. That was nice. Eye tint. Oh, is it around the eyes? That's fine, like that. I don't know what to name this character either. Some of these brows look rather malevolent. So a lot of the stuff, it's like the default is just fine the way it is. Brow high, brow high, okay. So we started here without... Rikki-dikki. Keep it the same. No. No. Jeez, no. Here. I don't know. Is that in a bun? Yeah. That's interesting. It looks like two different colors, though. Well, it looks like you've got, like, a mix with highlights and stuff. That's pretty cool. Yeah, no, and no here. So we got this. This was just two different darker baldness. There's hair and ornaments. I like that other one. Looks like his back as well. I don't know if that goes with her face. I like some of these hairs. We started in the middle, didn't we? Back in some way. There's a lot of in here. Holy crap. Kind of like that one. I kind of like this one. Actually, I think I'll take this one. Some of the longer ones just don't look right for her face. I don't know. Yeah, I like that one. That one's okay. It covers a lot of her face. I think she got a pretty face as it is, so... Yeah, this one. Hair color. You can go all kinds of... Interesting hair colors. Is this the closest to red? It's like pinkish. I like that. Really, I don't. What do I change the... Do I go done? I don't want a name to be completely always me. I don't have a way of getting down there. Finish and name your character. Does that mean finish and then I name my character? Name. Okay. So my main character in Skyrim is Amethyst, so... I think just for fun, I'll call it... Oh, Topaz? Topaz is a pretty cool name, isn't it?
Right, I remember. She fled from that civil war the Black Crescent caused, didn't she? Ironic, isn't it? Seems some parents pass on their fates to their children.
Anyway...
I'm gonna hit the hay for an hour or so. It's your turn to stand... You hear that?
Hear what?
Shit! Someone's coming!